YouTube, what's going on? It is very early on Sunday morning, and I apologize for the lack of activity on the channel this week. I've been sick and I've been working a lot, and so I apologize. But anyways, I found a couple of these. I found more, but I had to leave the rest for obvious reasons. But I do plan on getting, hopefully, at least a few more of these if I find them in the wild. This is going to be a hot car to have. Potentially valuable casting down the road. If it's anything like the other JDM castings from the 9-pack exclusives. The Land Cruiser is like a $230 car. The 4Runner is probably in the 50 or 60 range. So, definitely scoop one of these up. Alright, so a while back, I did my 3,500 subscriber giveaway. In that giveaway, I gave away pretty much one example of each brand. The highlight was the Tomica Limited Vintage EK9 Type R Honda Civic. Anyways, a couple months after sending out that package to the winner, who was Esoteric Nixon, who I didn't know until then, a couple months later, I got a box in the mail that had one of these in it. Now, the running boards were stripped off of it and it had been repainted red. But other than that, it's same casting. And I knew exactly what I was going to do with it. I wanted someone to customize it to make it look like my daily driver. And so I sent it off to Boogie Customs, who is one of the best in the business, in my opinion. And this is what we got. A really nice representation of my daily driver. It's a lot of really fine detail in this custom. So I'll try to go over all of it. We'll start with the headlights. Those are hand-painted custom headlights. Hand-painted grille. That is not a Lexus decal. That is hand-painted. The license plate, it's an Arizona plate. That obviously is a decal. Probably, I think, the coolest detail feature is the side view mirrors. That is quite incredible. The fact that he does the outline of the mirror in black to create the back shadow. Does that on both sides. And then all the taillight detail. You've got the brake light on top. And then you've got each brake light with reverse lights and indicators. Again, you have the Arizona plate. And better yet, and I don't know if the camera will pick this up, but he actually did the Lexus badge. I was getting it on camera, maybe from this angle. He actually did the Lexus badge and the LX470 and the V8 all in the correct font. And he did a clear bra. So the detail is, I mean, this dude does amazing, amazing work. So this is a true one-of-one The only one that exists. I don't think there's anything else even close to this that exists in 1 to 64 scale. I know that you can get these in 1 to 43rd, but to my knowledge, this is the only casting that exists in 1 to 64. Now, bear in mind, somebody actually commented on Instagram. That's a Land Cruiser, not a Lexus. It does say Land Cruiser on the base. Toyota Land Cruiser, but it's not a Land Cruiser. The Land Cruiser headlights and front grille are much different. This is the Lexus front end. So, there's a lot of reasons why that could have happened. I think the most likely reason is licensing. Maybe they were working on Lexus licensing and it didn't happen. I don't know. But I promise you, this is not a Toyota Land Cruiser. They're basically the same truck, basically, but there are subtle differences. And as an owner of one of these Lexuses, when I bought it, I wanted a Land Cruiser, so I did a lot of shopping. You can't buy the Land Cruisers for the price of the Lexus. They're way too expensive. And I know what you're thinking. Lexus is more expensive than Toyota. Well, that's probably true in most cases, but when it comes to the Land Cruiser, it is not true. It's not even close to being true. In fact, the Land Cruiser is probably about 50% more in most cases, double the price in some cases. The Land Cruiser is produced at a much lower clip, and therefore, the whole supply and demand thing, they command more money. So, but anyways, it's not a Land Cruiser, and it's just evident by the headlights. The Land Cruiser headlights are much, much, much different than this. So anyways, I'm super happy to have this in my collection. It's the first time in the 5 years that I've been collecting where I've been able to attain a replica of my daily driver. And let's see, when I started collecting, I had a 99 4Runner, so can't get that one in 1 to 64. After that, I had a 2002 Cadillac DeVille. I don't think there are any of those. And then after that, I got this. So, 3 cars in 5 years. This is the only one that even has a casting. All right. I recently scooped up a bunch of the Hot Wheels 50 Chevy Gassers and was able to flip them and make some money. So I'm going to be doing a little bit of shopping for either Kyosho or Tomica Limited Vintage or something like that. And so I was scrolling through eBay looking at Kyosho, and it just really gave me the urge to do a video. So this is the rest of the video is going to be exclusively Kyosho. Starting with this Ferrari 308, which unfortunately, if you guys have been subscribers of the channel, you've seen all these, but if you're anything like me, you might want to see them again. They really show how awesome Kyosho is. They make some incredible die cast. Ferrari 308. Here's a 512. Love this car. It's a hot car. As nice as this car is, I think the Tomica Testarossa is probably, it's probably a little bit better, other than the fact that the interior in it kind of sucks and the wheel or the tires are plastic. Other than those two things, I like that one better. But this one is still quite amazing. Look at the horse on the back there. That thing is so tiny. The fact that they got that amount of detail on that. Let's see if I can give you a scale reference here with this filthy, dirty penny. Here's a penny. That's your scale reference to the size of that horse. It's the size of one of the numbers on the date. I mean, that the fact that they're able to maintain that level of detail on such a small graphic is quite amazing. Not a lot of diecast brands can pull that off. This one here is probably equally as impressive. All of these cars roll. Not all Kyosho cars roll, but most of them do. All the ones I got out for this video do, although some of them, like this next one, don't roll all that great. This is a Mercedes-Benz C-Class. I love premium detailed Mercedes in this scale. It's a nice looking car. Nice taillights. Mercedes logo on this is also quite nice, although it's much larger than the horse on the Ferrari. A pothole there. I need to redo this road. Let's see, here's another Ferrari. This is a Mondeal. It's not the sexiest Ferrari, but it's still a really nice one. I do prefer the vintage Ferraris from Kyosho. There are a few modern Ferrari models that I like that. I have the LaFerrari and the Scuderia. I think it's a 430 Scuderia. And I wouldn't mind having a 458 Italia. There's probably a couple others that I wouldn't mind having. But for the most part, I like the classic, like 1990 and prior. And that's definitely a nice car. One thing I've learned too, collecting these, red is more expensive. I've talked about that before. But the silver ones probably look the best. Here's an example of that. This is the 512 BBI. And we'll get a good comparison with this one because Tomica brought it out. I think I might scoop one of those up. It's in the Tomica Premium lineup. I just can't imagine it's going to look this good. Now, the Tomica Limited Vintage Ferraris, when those are going to hit in March, that's going to be a different story because Tomica Limited Vintage is basically the cream. But this is amazing. I love this car. I love the color because the shadows, just, the lines, everything just pops. All the details pop. All the sculpted detail pops. And it just shows you how sexy the car is. Some of the mirrors on these Ferraris look kind of silly, but they are actual replicas of the actual mirrors on the cars. So that's the 512. So that's it for the Ferraris that I brought out. Really cute little car here is this Honda. Is this an S600 or 800? I always forget. S800. Little roadster, and it's tiny, but it is so awesome. A lot of detail in this little car. And to give you a scale reference on this car, here's the Penny. So the Penny takes up a little less than half. It's a tiny car, but it's true. It is true. 164. So there is that. Roadsters like this back in the 60s weren't very big. You had the MGs, the midgets, even the Jags were long, so they might have been a little different, but a lot of them were pretty small. I love that vintage Honda logo here in the grille. It's probably my favorite feature of this car. Now, Kyosho didn't make a lot of Hondas, and the ones that they did make were pretty limited, I think, because they're very hard to find, and when you find them, they're very expensive. I only have three Kyosho Hondas. I have that S800, I have a Honda City, which is anything but desirable. Then I have this Honda Civic, which is more of a desirable casting. And it's probably a $30 to $40 car, but it is a doozy. I'm not quite sure on the year. If any of you know the year, feel free to comment below. All of these cars have metal body plastic base construction with rubber tires. They all have transparent lensed headlights and taillights, and they all have prototypical wheels. Okay, one of my favorites is this Mazda Savanna. This is one of the ones that doesn't roll so well. It does roll, just not well. But this is another one of those cars that I just really like the lines of the car. Like, if I were to restore a Japanese classic car. This one would make my final five. If I could do any car I wanted, it would be a Kenmare GTR, which are very rare. So I'd probably never afford one of those because I think that's a six-figure car. But this one would definitely make the list. I don't know if it'd make the final cut, but I really do like these RX3s. Very, very nice looking lines. I can tell you, I wouldn't do a Nissan Z just because, the Z is like the Japanese Mustang in that there are a lot of them out there. So here is the Kenmare GTR that I just mentioned. This is, if I could own any classic Japanese car, this would be the one. Some people are Hakko people, some people are R32 people, some people like the R34. Some people like the GTR, but me personally, I like the Kenmare because I like the look of the fastback. I see a lot of American inspiration in this car. You look at when this car came out, the Mustangs were all the buzz in the US. The fastback look, which I'm pretty sure originated in the United States, made its way over to the land of the rising sun. While I think that the Japanese die-cast companies do a much better job than the American die-cast companies, I won't go so far as to say that this fastback looks better than a Mustang. I don't know that it looks better. It just has way more cool factor to it. These black wheels are killing me because they make it impossible. They just absorb all the light and it just sucks. I want to try to show you guys these wheels. Because if there's one thing that Kyosho beats Tomica Limited Vintage in, well, there's two things. Wheels and tires and stance. These are just basic black steelies, but as you can see, they're not. See if I can get this thing to focus. There you go. There's a ton of detail. You've got the four bolt pattern. But there's not a lot to these. These are steelies, and even Greenlight and Auto World make really nice looking steelies. But Kyosho never misses on the stance. You'll never see a goofy stance on a Kyosho casting. They just don't exist. Unless the stance on the actual car was goofy. Okay, here's a more modern European car, the Audi A5. Very nice looking car. I'm not a big fan of Audi, but I do like the Kyosho Audis because they do a great job replicating them. You've got the little Audi logo there with the really nice transparent lensed headlights and very subtle what look to be indicators. I'm assuming those are indicators, those little circular things there. It looked like fog lights down there on the bottom part of the bumper. The wheels, as I mentioned, Kyosho dominates diecast when it comes to wheels. Because Greenlight and Auto World and Johnny Lightning and those type of brands, they'll make a wheel that can pass for OEM, but that's also generic enough to be used on other cars. And it's a money thing, They don't want a wheel tooling for every car. That gets very expensive to do. Well, Kyosho does that. Each car has the OEM wheel that came on the car. The only two major brands that I know of that do that are Tomoka Limited Vintage and Kyosho. Auto World, I don't even think, does that because they've got some generic aftermarket wheels like the Torque Thrusts. And they have some, just I think some basic mag wheels as well as steelies, because steelies can be basically be used on anything. But Kyosho makes the wheels specific to the car for each model. They don't get, you won't see this set of wheels on another model. And Tomoka Limited Vintage does that too. However, they, in my opinion, don't do nearly as good of a job as Kyosho because a lot of theirs, it's I don't know how to articulate it verbally, but they're not it's almost like the wheel is a solid piece and then the design of the wheel is sculpted, but it doesn't, I don't know how to put it. Okay, so like with this one here, where you've got the five spokes and there's a gap in between each spoke, with Tomoka Limited Vintage, you don't get that most of the time. You'll get the five spokes, but then there'll be plastic behind it as part of the wheel. And sometimes they'll paint the back shadow, which will make it look more realistic, but sometimes they don't. And then there are some cars that they do that do have the openings in the wheels. Some of the later model stuff, like the R33 Skyline and the RX3 or RX7 that just came out. Here's another classic European car. This is a Maserati Ghibli or Ghibli, maybe. It's a pretty bitchin' car. Big old long European GT car. I mean, all of these cars are bitchin', so that kind of goes without saying. So, for all you kids that are watching, I do try to be family friendly, so if you ever say that word, because that's a bad word. You have to use it in that context. And then it's not offensive to anybody. And specifically, use it when referencing a car that you think is, well, bitchin'. Like this one. I'm sure if you saw one of these on the road, well, I don't know. I don't want to get too. All right, so this is a Toyota, which I'm a big fan of Toyotas, big fan of Kyosho, so this is a great combination. Kyosho did their Toyota stuff very early on. It was well before I was a collector. And they didn't ever do anything later on, so. What they did do, though, is they did the Mechanical Doctor set, which is where you get this one. In that six car set, you got this Celica, you also got a Sports 800, and you also got a 2000 GT. They also did a Toyota 86 three car set, which goes for about $100 now, where you had a Sprinter and a Trueno And you had the new Toyota 86. But other than those, like, subset releases, they haven't done anything Toyota. This one's pretty cool, though. I like the aftermarket wheels. I think they're kind of cool looking. Yeah, this is based off of, I think it was a cartoon, a Japanese cartoon. But awesome detail on this car. The taillights look great. And I love anytime I can get some nice premium detailed Toyota, I'm all about that. There's not a ton of it out there, but they can be found. Okay, we're working down. We've only got actually two more cars. This one here is a Lancia. I did confirm that I am pronouncing that right. It's not Lancia. It's Lancia. It's a two-syllable pronunciation. It would be phonetical. It would be Lancia. Lancia. And this is a killer little car. This one came by way of Lamar Fashion. I think this is the only car of this assortment that I got from him. But I did get a nice little Kyosho collection from him. And this is a really cool little car. I love it. Great stance, great detail, great proportions. I love the wheels. But then again, I love all Kyosho wheels because they're all pretty much on point. This one's a really nice roller, too. Oh, yeah, let's look at these taillights real quick. So you got your taillights, indicators, and reverse lights, all transparent, lensed, and colored. And then in the grill, you've got this awesome looking grill with the side-by-side round headlight lenses. Very cool car. The last car here, I've had more people try to get this car off of me than any other car in my entire collection. And I'm not ever gonna trade it or sell it. I've decided it's just not gonna happen. I've looked on eBay and you cannot find this car. You can find it, you just can't find this version of it with these wheels. Impossible to find. All the ones that show up on eBay have different wheels and they don't look nearly as good because they're not the deep dish wheels like these are. And it makes a big difference in the look. I mean, I see why everybody wants this car. It's an absolutely killer car. I think it's better than the TLV. And there aren't many cars that I would say that about. But this one, I mean, look at that. That's just so killer. So this is the 1981. I think it's 81. It might be 82. And it's the Nissan Skyline. What is it? 2000 GTX. No, 2000 Turbo RSX. And it's also known as the R30 Skyline, which is the one Hot Wheels just put out not too long ago. The Hot Wheels one, it's a little bit different. It has round taillights, But it is the same body style. The Hot Wheels one is a 1982. And actually, if you look, this one has round taillights as well. They're just, you've got these square lenses, and then within the square lenses, you have the, you can see there, you have two round taillights in each lens. It's not that distinctive, which is unfortunate, but it's probably accurate to the car. So, I've never really mentioned this on the channel. I'm sure you all have noticed it, that when handling the cars, my fingerprints get all over them. They're all in mint condition. They just need the fingerprints wiped off. Fingerprints, they wipe right off. And I always give them a good wipe before I put them back in the carny, because I don't want the oils of my skin to, not saying it would cause a reaction with the paint, but it's possible. And if you look, there are already issues. This is not exclusive to Kyosho. Konami is the same way. The only brand over there that I know of that has no paint issues is Tomica Limited Vintage. I don't have a lot of paint issues with Kyosho. In fact, I don't have many at all. But with Konami, it's a pretty regular thing with Konami. I think they used a very cheap paint on their cars. But anyways, that's the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I wasn't expecting it to take 40 minutes. So if you got all the way through that, I appreciate it. I hope you enjoyed the content. And if you guys want a very cool custom, I'm pretty sure his moniker is Boogie underscore E7 underscore customs. It's BUGI underscore E3 underscore CUSTOMS. He, in my opinion, he's right up there with the best. The true quality of this casting here, this custom, it doesn't come through on camera. If I had it outside in natural light, it might. Maybe I will do that, because that little Instagram video that I did was, I couldn't get the camera to focus properly, so that's why it makes this look more silver than it is. But trust me when I tell you, the work on this thing is, it's just incredible. There's no bleeding in any of the paint seams, no shaky lines. I'm sure you guys noticed, but like all of the panels, he details all of the joints to give it all depth, to make it look more realistic. You take a casting like this that has a lot of really good sculpted detail, and you start putting primer and paint and another coat of paint, pretty soon all the sculpted detail starts to disappear. And so what he does is he goes in with what looks to be a wash and just brings out that detail. And to me, a lot of people might not like it. I like it because I think it gives it a more realistic look. Now you want to see the door jams, If you're looking at a real car, you're gonna see that. You're gonna see those. You're gonna see the gas cap. I want to see that stuff. And yeah, he did it on the hood. The clear bra just kills me. Everything, all the detail in this car, it just blows me away. He even did that. I just now noticed that. He did it right there on the roof rack, or luggage rack, as it were. He did it around the rear hatch. You can see all that back shadow. And let's see. Wow, I didn't even notice that. He's got something at the top here to the left of the brake light. I'm very curious what that is. I would be absolutely shocked if that was a mistake. I sent him an exact close up of all four sides of my truck, the front, the back, and both sides. So he knows what all, he knows, he knew what all it was gonna require. So I'm pretty sure for him to put that black dot there, it's there for a reason. So now I need to figure out what it is. I'll have to do that. Anyways, thanks everybody. 41 minutes. Have a good Sunday. I will be back with you later this week. Not sure with what, but still waiting on quite a bit of stuff. Waiting on some people to ship some stuff, and hopefully I'll have that stuff soon so that I can show you guys. But until then, you all take care, and I will holler at the next video.